G'day everyone, Alex here from Paperform, and today I'm going to share with you how you can connect your Paperform account with your Trello. Now, Trello is a visual project management tool. It empowers your team to manage any project, workflow, or task. So, let's take a look. Here I've created a simple form that prompts a submitter to input details on an upcoming project. When the submitter completes the form and hits the submit button, I want to update my Trello. More specifically, I want to create a new card within my Trello board, and that's so that my team and I can begin working on the project. Now, to do this, from your form editor, navigate to After Submission, Integrations, and Webhooks. Below Direct Integrations, select Trello and the action you want to trigger. In this case, I'll select Create Card. Now, you're redirected to the integration setup. It's here you're prompted to connect your Trello account, so select the Add Account button and follow the prompts. Now, I'm adding a new card to a Trello board, so I'll need to select the correlating board, which is titled My Trello Board. Next, you'll need to select the list you want your card assigned to. For me, I'm going to select Upcoming. And now it's time to configure the card name. While you can manually type your card name, you can also follow the process of answer piping and display a submitter's response to a particular question. Just select the icon on the right-hand side here, which will display the questions of your form. Simply select the question of which you want to dynamically display the submitter's response to, and voila. Each time the form is submitted, the card name will be that of your submitter's response to your selected question. Now, you can leave the card description empty. However, this is a great opportunity to provide more details on the project. So I'm going to pipe in the submitter's response to my question, project details. We're almost finished. You also have the ability to enable logic rules. Much like with the visibility of elements within your form, you can configure a direct integration to only trigger under certain conditions. Now, perhaps you only want your Trello to be updated when a submitted response to a question with a particular answer. This is where you can achieve that. Now, I'm going to leave this section blank, but be sure to check out the description of this video for an article looking at Paperform logic. Now it's time to send a test. Once you're happy with the integration, be sure that you've run a test submission of your form so that Paperform can test the connection between Trello and Paperform with real data. Once you're ready, select Send Test. And there we have it, success. So if you navigate into your Trello dashboard, you'll see that the integration has been successful. And there we have it. I have a new card created within my Trello board under the upcoming list. And all that's left to do is jump back into the integration setup and select Finish Setup. Sweet. Now, form submissions will automatically create a new card within my Trello board. If at any time you want to turn off your integration, scroll to the bottom of Integrations and Webhooks and toggle that button there. You can also select the toggle icon to edit, delete, duplicate, and look at the history of your integration. Well, I hope that's been a helpful video. And if it has, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more helpful videos on all things Paperform. Well, good luck and have fun creating.